Fishin' Affliction. Hello.
Rise and shine. It's Fishin' Affliction time. For those who got it bad.
Well, Mom and Dad's grab the kids, it's time for the fishing show. Me and old Rusty's gonna go catch them down at the fishing hole. Well, you better stick around, cause you don't know what you're missing. Yeah, me and old Rusty's got that fishing affliction. Grab your hats, grab your baits, and don't forget your poles. We're gonna fire up that old Ranger boat and head to the fishing hole. We're gonna try to catch a big one. Yeah, that's what we're wishing. Cause me and old Rusty's got that fishing affliction. Yeah, me and old Rusty's got that fishing affliction. Yeah. Man, and we've got it bad.
We've got that fishing affliction.
Just like me. Here, fishy, fishy here, fishy, fishy here, fishy, fishy here.
This is just a never-ending story.
Rise and shine. It's Fishin' Affliction time, and thank you for tuning in again this morning. This is your old pal Matthew Gillen, the voice of Fishin' Affliction here at the HD Studios. Thanks to these emails from a ton of you, we're going to grant your request. We're going to go back to Nickajack for a third time to show you those record-breaking catches again, plus some more footage that you didn't get to see on the last two historic shows. Thank you for the great idea. Coming up at the end of the show, our weekly Team Fishin' Affliction t-shirt giveaway. If you're entered, I might be announcing your name. If you haven't entered, stay tuned. I'll get you some more information. Sit back and relax and enjoy the third wave of our attack on Nickajack on Fishin' Affliction TV.
I lost one right off the bat.
That's a big bass. He didn't come up.
Well, folks, just like Matthew said, you requested it, so we're going to do it for you. We had such an overwhelming response from so many of you viewers of Fishin' Affliction that couldn't believe the fish that we caught down at the Jack. And what you don't know is that we actually went there 7 days later for our second trip. Now, we didn't catch the fish like we did on that first trip, and there were so many fish from the first trip that didn't even make the shows that this episode is going to cover both the fish we didn't show you, plus a few that you do want to see, and some things that you didn't see at all.
Hey, Charles. You ever seen Rusty's twin?
Hey, this is Dan before he started on Jimmy Craig.
Good morning, Charles. How are you today?
I'm fine, Dan. How are you?
Oh, just I'm happy now that I'm seeing you in the boat because I know where we're at.
Yeah.
Did you have a good day fishing yesterday?
Yeah.
Good.
Had a good day.
Now, how come you got so many clothes on this morning time?
It's cold this morning.
Thought springtime was here.
Yeah.
Big largemouth.
There's a big largemouth.
Look at that. That's a good fish. That's a good
largemouth
right there.
Start out with.
Real good solid largemouth. We're going to go ahead and box him. We'll go ahead and box him. That's a good solid fish. Good Charles, fish. Will you do me the honors this morning?
Yeah.
Thank you, sir.
I got it.
Down here with our buddy Charles starting out this morning. Gonna have another fun day fishing, I can tell already.
Well, folks, there's no doubt that one of my favorite things to see is a sunrise at Nickajack, because I know when we're there, we're gonna catch a lot of fish. And we have done so every time that we've gone there. And that last trip, of course, was record setting for Fishin' Affliction TV. But just 7 days later, when we decided to go back to the Jack, well, this trip turned out to be our most difficult trip that we've ever experienced at the Jack in our attempts to catch fish. And the big dog, well, he was hard at it trying to figure out what he needed to do to put him in the boat.
I'm having the losies this morning. I lost two, had them halfway back, and they pull off. And I'm not doing something right. I'm just trying to figure it out now, because I'm either not getting a good hook in them, they're just not getting the hook good. I don't know, but I've had two really good fish on and lost both of them.
Well, after making a few adjustments, it wasn't long before the big dog put another one in the boat.
That's a good fish. That was a good fish. Boy, that one eat it up. That one eat that bait up.
He didn't want that jig, did he?
He wanted it.
Look. You know there you got the right color and the right bait when you can't, when there's a jig, you know that's the right bait to be throwing.
Yeah. Look at that fish's tail.
Oh yeah.
Bloody.
Good solid largemouth. We're not getting the smallmouth bites this morning, but we are catching some good solid largemouth. So, good way to start the day anyway.
Well, folks, by popular request, our attack of the jack number 3. And we'll be back there in the wilds of Nickajack in just a few moments. But right now, let's go see some pictures from this week's
In the Wild. Your pictures in the wild. Brought to you by Express Pull and Save. Your home for low price, self-serve, auto parts, saving you money.
Well, folks, I have finally met the ultimate outdoorsman. This is Jim Summers, and you'll know that name because this is the man who won the very first Fishin' Affliction t-shirt giveaway. Now, at the beginning, you saw the turkey that Jim took this year, and there's some bass, and here's a hybrid. And note the shirt. That's right. That's the Team Fishin' Affliction shirt, and it must be a good luck charm because look at that mess of crappie that Jim caught while wearing his Team Fishin' Affliction jersey. Folks, you can send your pictures to pics@fishandaffliction.com and be sure to check out all the picture galleries there at the website. And be sure to send us your pictures, because maybe you'll see them right here on the big screen.
In the Wild. Your pictures in the wild. Brought to you by Express Pull and Save. Your home for low price, self-serve, auto parts, saving you money. Conveniently located, Express Pull and Save offers a huge and continually updated inventory of vehicles for your automotive needs. Their simple, state-of-the-art customer service terminal will help you locate parts so you can pull and save. Bumpers, taillights, wheels and rims, switches, mirrors, seats, and much more. The friendly, courteous staff at Pull and Save make it so easy, even if you're the big dog.
Hey, big dog.
What?
Pull and Save's on that side of the fence.
But don't you think these will look good on the Ranger?
Express Pull and Save, saving you money. Smyrna Ready Mix is an established company that handles business daily with integrity and professionalism. Whether you're a general contractor, professional builder, or do-it-yourself homeowner, SRM has your concrete solutions. With several locations in the Middle Tennessee area to serve you, the only call you need to make is to SRM, ready to serve you with integrity and professionalism. The Tournament Trail. For those who've got it bad, brought to you by SRM, Smyrna Ready Mix, serving you with professionalism and integrity.
Well, folks, here's the tournament trail results for the Home Builders Bass Trail for a tournament held on the 19th of April out on Percy Priest. First place with 20.50 pounds, a team of John Bornstein and David Genevico. Second place with 18.60 pounds, a team of Nathan Vaughn and Trey Bain. Now, third place was the team of Jeremy Etheridge and John Hopkins with 14.90 pounds. And fourth place and first big fish of the tournament was Joe Haas and our very own Rusty Rust. Congratulations to all those who participated, and thanks to the Home Builders Trail for supplying those tournament results. Folks, you can send your tournament results to info@fishandaffliction.com, and be sure to check out all the tournament trail links there at fishandaffliction.com so you can keep up with all of those who are on the trail. Thanks to Smyrna Ready Mix for being the sponsor of the Fishin' Affliction Tournament Trail. And now, back to Fishin' Affliction. Folks, welcome back to Fishin' Affliction, and this segment of the show is brought to you by our new sponsor, Clark Marine, down in Franklin, Tennessee. They offer the very best of Ranger boats, Triton boats, Sea Arcs, Express Aluminum boats, Sea Rays, and Veranda pontoon boats. And folks, they have been serving you with excellence for over 30 years. For all your boating needs, be sure to see Stuart and the award-winning team of Clark Marine, and check out their incredible interactive website at clarkmarine.com down in Franklin, Tennessee.
That's a good fish.
It's
a good fish, Brother Dan. I hope that's a big largemouth.
I think it's a tugging straight down, big dog.
And that's a big fish, whatever it is.
On our razor rod, it's making a... I'm thinking it might be foul, though, too. But I could be wrong in all accounts. Get this fish in. Now let me ask you this, Charles, is this what we come for?
That's a big old drum.
Let me just ask you, is that a big bug eye drum? Look at the eyes on this thing.
Dan, you are a drum fishing fiend.
Look at the bug eyes on him.
I think it's going.
Oh man, I missed one.
I think it's going to be a day where we catch everything.
I think so. How do you like that? All right. Boy, why don't you go back to fishing so I can do what I need to do?
I really like taking pictures of you. Why don't you hold up the big drum?
We'll have to see if the end of Skillet Gal can do something with these sometime, because we sure catch some big ones out here, don't we?
It's nothing but a freshwater redfish.
That's all it is.
That's all it is.
All right.
Well, after the big dog got done making fun of my fish, it was time to turn it loose and see if I could catch something other than a big drum.
I don't think he's a monster, big dog. Nice spot.
He's got a belly on that fish.
That's a good looking spot.
Getting ready.
And you're having a little trouble. I'm gonna get you set your own professional set of pliers this morning. That's a good chunk. That's
beautiful,
a good
fish, aren't they?
Good chunky spot.
That's about locked out what I eat when I eat them.
All righty. All right.
That's a half ounce football head with a rage tail.
Well, folks, after that big old drum and that good sized spotted bass, I ended up catching something I've never caught before at the jack.
I think at the keeper, he's going to measure at least 12 inches. I think he's going to measure 12 feet.
Well, after catching this monster rope and getting a few more chuckles from the big dog, it was finally time for him to catch another fish.
Catching largemouth. There's another one. Probably go ahead and let this one go. We probably won't put it on our string weight. Anyway. Another keeper fish. Three largemouth, no smallmouth yet. But we're wanting them big smallmouth.
Well, folks, you can want them all you want to. But when you get the bite, you gotta be able to catch them.
That one's hold. I'm doing everything I could just to get him to come on out. Dang it. That one's hold. What am I doing wrong, man? I'm getting them halfway back and they're pulling loose. Quit laughing. It ain't funny. Hard to do a TV show without no fish. He was coming up the jump. He just pulled. I'm shooting him. Turn the camera off. Give me your gun, Charles.
Okay. Well, that was a decent spot. Decent spot.
Now, if you really were going to say what you wanted to say, what were you going to say?
Dang it. Dang it, man. That's the third one that I've had halfway back or closer that I have lost. I mean, that one right there, he come off at the boat.
Well.
Okay.
That one never had the chance to get to the boat, did it?
You know, certain days I really like you. I mean, I think you're a fine, upstanding human being. This ain't the day.
This ain't the day? I tell you what, though, your new shirt looks great.
Well, thank you, Dan. If you can't catch them good, you may as well look good, huh?
That really does look nice.
That was a good solid spot right there, wasn't it, Charles?
Yeah.
I mean, we hadn't been getting the spot bites this year yet, and I'm glad to see them, a few of them start to show up. Dan had two on and a minute ago, but you didn't get to see them on the camera either. I'm just going to emphasize that because he's trying to emphasize this. So.
Well, since the big dog and I couldn't seem to catch one, it was up to Charles to see if he could put one in the boat.
Hey, one of them hit the boat. How about it?
Spot.
Well, that's about the fifth or sixth one we've had on, ain't it?
That's the first one in 4 hours.
It ain't always easy, is it?
Well, folks, we're having a ball there down at Nickajack with the old man of the river, Charles Sullivan. And right now, it's time for the Clark Marine Weekly Team Fish and Affliction Special. Now, this is a brand new 2011 Triton 18 Explorer with a 115 horsepower Mercury Optimax on the back. This boat has it all. It's got a 70-pound thrust Minn Kota Edge trolling motor, it's got a deluxe dash, it's got an automatic bilge pump, and this Triton is built with an all-composite construction that comes with a lifetime limited structural hull warranty. And this boat has a great price, folks, $21,760 plus tax after a $1,500 Triton rebate. Get on down there to see Stuart and the award-winning team of Clark Marine and tell them Fish and Affliction sent you. And folks, we'll be back in just a few minutes. Right now, let's go see what Miss Vic has got cooking this week.
In the Skillet with Chef Vicki Porter is brought to you by Kleepy.com, turning your precious memories into video treasures.
Welcome to In the Skillet. I'm Vicki Porter, and today I'm going to be making a healthy and delicious treat for you. It's my roasted asparagus. And now for the ingredients. You will need asparagus spears, olive oil, Parmesan cheese, minced garlic, salt and pepper, and lemon juice. With your asparagus in a bowl, drizzle some olive oil and mix in your minced garlic. Toss this all together and get it evenly coated. Next, add your Parmesan cheese and season with your salt and pepper. Place your asparagus in a baking dish and then bake this at 425 for about 15 minutes. After about 15 minutes, you'll be ready to enjoy this healthy and delicious roasted asparagus. You can find this recipe at my new website, intheskillet.com. I'm Vicki Porter. Tune in next week to see what's cooking in the skillet.
This may be kind of like if you kind of steady. Then if you pop it a little bit, you know,
it's kind of like this, all over, like that.
There's no way I'm going to do that.
I believe it's like this. It's like this.
Yeah, it's kind of like this.
No way.
It does a lot of this.
Kind of like this.
The sexy swimmer, it's got action you can't believe until you see it. There.
Hello everyone, I'm Doug Markham. Please tune in every Saturday on 99.7 WTN here in Middle Tennessee to hear my radio show. I talk to some great sportsmen about the outdoors, some real experts, and I think you'll enjoy them. Getting the serious drive time guys from 5 to 7 a.m. And then if you like fishing reports and other outdoor news, come to DougOutdoors.com. I'm always updating it and trying to get some good news to you.
Only brought to you by Fishin' Affliction, for those that are bad, both on the water and in the woods.
Folks, let's join Affliction Prostaffer Catfish on a recent turkey hunt.
Well, it was exciting this evening. I didn't hear anything for the first 30 minutes after I got there, I guess. About 30 minutes before dark, this gobbler, he hammered. I hit him with that river otter box call, that mad river otter box call, and that Billy Yargus mouth call. It didn't take but about 10 minutes. And here you come. Strutted up there and I shot him about 40 yards.
Well, congratulations to Affliction Prostaffer Catfish. And now, back to Fishin' Affliction.
It's time for Fishin' 101, brought to you by Maryville Middle Bass Club. Now here's Carla.
Thanks, guys. In today's segment, we want to talk about the importance of wearing a life jacket. This is a state law for children 12 and under, but it is a great idea for everyone, regardless of your age. Make sure your life jacket is Coast Guard approved and check the label to ensure it supports your size and weight. Anglers who are 16 years or older may want to check out the new inflatable vests on the market. Regardless of the vest you choose, make sure that it's capable of keeping your chin above the water. So remember guys, no matter how bad your fishing is going, you can always keep your chin up. I'm Carla and this has been Fishing 101 with the Maryville Middle School Bass Club.
Oh, what a smallmouth. Wow. That is a jaw. Get the net. Get the net. That is a big, big, big smallmouth right there.
Well, folks, welcome back to Fishin' Affliction, and this portion of the show is brought to you by the ever-powerful DECA Gel Batteries, Razor Rods, and our brand new reel sponsor, U.S. Reel, when performance means everything. Now, these reels are unbelievably advanced, folks, and we are looking forward to sharing with you this technology here on Fishin' Affliction. And in the next few episodes, that's exactly what we'll be doing. But right now, you asked for it, so here they are, the big fish that you wanted to see that we've caught down at the Jack, starting with my big 6 1/4 pound smallmouth.
Oh, that's a big fish. Oh my goodness, what a big fish. That fish is a 6 pounds of jaw right there, probably.
Oh, yeah.
That is a monster smallmouth right there. That is a monster. An absolute monster. Look at that fish. That is a monster. Good job, boy. Woo!
Ooh. Oh my goodness.
Good smallmouth. Real good smallmouth. That's a real good smallmouth.
Where is he, big dog? Where is he?
Right there he goes. He's sounding.
Famous.
Real good smallmouth.
He just decided, didn't he?
Real good smallmouth. Woo! That's a good smallmouth. Woo, man, he ate that football. Look how long that smallmouth is.
That fish is nearly 20 inches long, bro.
Oh, what a smallmouth. Oh, God, that's a smallmouth.
There he goes. Smallmouth to me.
Oh, my goodness, what a big smallmouth. Big old smallmouth, man.
Big.
Big smallmouth. Real big smallmouth. Ooh, that's a big old smallmouth.
Oh, man, that's a dandy. I'm bad.
Let me tell you what, don't
don't think a big heavy jig won't catch a big smallmouth, because that's a big one right there. Big, big old smallmouth on a big striking jig. I tell you, man, they are eating that thing, boy.
Look at him come, boy. Woo! Look at that smallmouth, boy. That is a big old smallmouth right there.
That is a big one. That is a big one. Oh, my goodness.
Lay down, big. Oh, my goodness. No, that's a large mouth.
That's a large mouth.
That is a big, large mouth. Big old large mouth. Woo! Golly, boy. What a fun day.
Oh, man. Awesome, big dog. Okay. He's a tugging, isn't he, Charles?
Ooh. That's a big, large mouth.
Yeah.
Big, large mouth.
That's Watch good. My pole there, Charles. I got it in your way. Sorry about that.
Don't matter.
Woo! <Good. laughs> Yeah!
There you go, big dog.
What do you think of that?
That's doing good.
First of the day, Dan.
And what happened when you changed your shirt?
That's it.
That's exactly right. Ooh, what a largemouth. Man.
That is a thing. That is a thing, too. Let me help you, Ooh. Here. Let me help you. Come here, boy. Open up the mat. There you go. Here, let me take off your jig. Here's your fish. Another 4-pounder. Man, what a day fishing. I mean, what a day.
Pretty fish.
Well, folks, I hope you've enjoyed the requested episode of our Attack of the Jack, featuring the last two trips that we've taken down there with the old man of the river. That first trip, well, that was one for the record books. The second trip, although it was a little more difficult to catch the fish, we sure enjoyed the time, and both Rusty and I sincerely appreciate spending time with Charles Ray. And folks, we sincerely appreciate spending time with you each and every Saturday morning, and thank you for all the response that you're giving to us. And next week, we're busting out our brand new U.S. reels. So join us next week for Fishin' Affliction.
This week's winner of the great-looking Team Fishin' Affliction t-shirt made by ACP Specialties in Andersonville is Trent Schaefer of Hohenwald, Tennessee. Everyone who enters will be qualified for the Fishin' Affliction Grand Prize drawing later this year. The grand prize is your very own Fishin' Affliction episode. Plus, you'll also win an assortment of other fishing goodies. See website for official details. So get your entry in now at fishinaffliction.com. A big thanks to all of our sponsors. They're committed to bringing you the highest quality products and services. And this is your old pal Matthew Gillen, the voice of Fishin' Affliction TV. Hoping that you'll tune in next week, because there's no doubt that Dan and the Big Dog got it bad. They've got Fishin' Affliction for those who got it bad.
Rusty's catching today.
I'll bet you anything.
Here, watch it like this.
A striking bait. That's it.
Nothing safe around me.